In this video, I am going to talk about Celtic myth.
Actually, that's not how you pronounce.
But I'm actually nerd. I haven't even done my intro yet. Can I at least do that? Thank you. As I was saying, in this video, I am going to talk about Celtic mythology.
Actually, that's not how you pronounce it.
Heavy machine gun.
And with that taken care of, I can now begin. So, as regular viewers of my channel could guess, I really wanted to make a video power scaling the Celtic pantheon. But the Celtic gods are not as well known as the Nordic gods or the Greek gods. So I feel that before we talk about power levels, we should get familiar with this pantheon first. In this video then, we will explore the mythology. We will only focus on the story. And then, in the next video, we will talk about what would happen if the Celtic gods punch a carrot. Okay, now, first, let's get familiar with their names. The Celtic gods are many, but only five of them are the most important. Their names are the Dagda, oldest and chief deity of the Celtic pantheon, Morrigan, the wife of the Dagda, Lugh, the warrior god, Angus, the most important son of the Dagda, and Nuadhu, the king of the Celtic gods. Although regulars of this channel have already been briefly exposed to this deity under a different name. Nodens. Yeah, that's the link, that's why I used the same pick! Did you get it? However, when discussing Celtic mythology, we will refer to this deity as Nuadhu. Alright, now that you know their names, I can tell you their story. And, as it is often the case, we will start at the beginning. In the beginning, there was the Dagda and his wife, Morrigan. We don't know where they come from, if they had an origin story. This information has been lost to time. But with the primary sources that are available to us today, we deduce that they were first. Then, for reasons that have also been lost, or perhaps never existed in the first place, the Dagda decides to create his own realm. It is called Tir Tangir. This is Celtic heaven, and lucky for us, it is also known by a much simpler name, the Fairy Mound. After the Dagda creates the Fairy Mound, he and his wife Morrigan presumably lay together, and they produce the rest of the gods. Now, Morrigan has many children, but three of them are her favorites. Their names are Brian, Luchar, and Lucharba. Morrigan likes them above the rest, because these three are very talented with magic. Usually, together as a group, these three are known as the Three Gods of Danu. Danu, by the way, is another name for Morrigan. The Celtic gods have all more than one name. This is very common in mythology, a god usually is known in more than one way. However, for this video, I am going to refer to the Three Gods of Danu as the Three Children of Morrigan. Now, why are the Three Children of Morrigan relevant to the story? Well, they will be important in a bit, but for now, let's continue. So, once the Celtic gods are born, the god Lugh introduces into existence the concept of assembly. In other words, having a meeting, and he also introduces the concept of arguing during a meeting. A funny way of phrasing it, yes, but this is just an elaborate way of saying that after the Celtic gods were born, they started to argue with each other. And it was the god Lugh who started this. But what are they arguing about? Well, we can take a guess, because after the gods are born, the Dagda gives to each god their own domain in the Fairy Mound. And so, each god gets to enjoy ruling over their own land. For a time then, there is peace and happiness. Until one day, the Dagda goes to visit one of his fellow deities, the god Nechtan. And I would like to stress, the Dagda went there to visit his old buddy Nechtan. How dare you question him? Really, he had no ulterior motives. So you must believe me when I tell you that what it's about to happen was not the Dagda's fault. Verily I tell you, the Dagda would not lie. So the Dagda goes to visit the god Nechtan, and Nechtan's wife, the goddess Bond, asks the Dagda to sleep together. So they do, and Bond gives birth to a son named Angus. After the affair, the Dagda gives Angus to the god Midir, so that Angus can be raised without Nechtan knowing what happened. Now, Nechtan had a special well. In this well, there were magical fishes, and if anyone ate the fishes, that person would become really smart. To protect the well, Nechtan made it so that the water of the well was aggressive towards anyone except Nechtan and a select few. After Bond gives birth to Angus, she goes to the well to hide her guilt, whatever that means, and the water water of the well kills her. As for Nechtan, he is irrelevant from this point forward, I will not mention him again, but presumably he is still around. Same goes for Midir, by the way. Now, let's focus on Angus because he actually matters. When Angus discovers that he is the son of the Dagda, he goes to the Dagda and asks for his own domain. Unfortunately, the Dagda tells him that he cannot give him anything, because the Dagda does not have any more land to give. And hearing this, Angus then asks to the Dagda, "Can I stay in your realm until the sun and the moon go away?" The Dagda thinks that this is a reasonable request, and so the Dagda allows Angus to stay in his home. 24 hours later, the Dagda tells to Angus, "Time's up, you gotta leave. Good luck out there, what a great father." When Angus hears this, he's confused, and he tells to the Dagda, "But father, you told me that I could stay in your realm until the sun and the moon went away." The Dagda then realized that he had been tricked. Without thinking about it, the Dagda agreed that Angus could stay in his domain until the sun and the moon died. The Dagda gave away his realm, which is technically all of Celtic heaven. Checkmate, Dagda. Humiliated and outsmarted, the Dagda tells to the rest of the gods to abandon heaven. For Angus will be king, but his kingdom will be empty. However, as the saying goes, when it rains, it pours. During the time the gods are planning to leave the fairy mound, the father of the god Lug is killed. Lug's father is called Sian, and he was killed by the three children of Morrigan. But why, you may ask? Well, it turns out that the Dagda, Sian, and their respective families, they do not get along for reasons that we are not given. And so, one day, when Sian was walking by himself, the three children of Morrigan saw him, and well, they decided to jump him. When Lug discovers what the three children of Morrigan did, he is not happy. The three children of Morrigan are convinced that Lug is going to kill them. But to their surprise, the god Lug sends them on a quest instead. All the three children of Morrigan have to do is collect a couple of magical artifacts for Lug. And if they manage to acquire these items, the god Lug will forgive them. This quest, however, was a trick, and the three children of Morrigan knew it. The items that the god Lug demanded were extremely difficult to acquire. And so, the three children of Morrigan had two options. They could either refuse the quest and die right away, or they could accept the quest and almost certainly die trying. But there was a small chance that they could succeed. The three children of Morrigan then, of course, decided to try, and to everyone's surprise, they succeeded. Unfortunately, the three children of Morrigan were mortally wounded in the process of acquiring these magical artifacts. Luckily for them, or so the three children of Morrigan thought, among the magical items that they acquired for Lug, there was one artifact that had the power to heal them. With their final breaths, the three children of Morrigan begged Lug to save them, but the god Lug had a final trick up his sleeve. The agreement was that if the three children of Morrigan succeeded on their quest, Lug would not kill them, but it was never agreed that they would live. The three children of Morrigan were not killed, but they did die. In a particular version of this chain of events, it is said that after the three children of Morrigan die, the Dagda gets so sad about the death of his sons that he too also dies. And now, while grieving and more divided than ever, the Celtic gods leave heaven. Before doing this, however, Morrigan is of the opinion that the gods, as a group, should have a name. And so, in honor of her three children, Morrigan names the Celtic gods Tua de Danann. This means the people of Danu. And once again, Danu is just another name for Morrigan. From now on then, whenever I'm talking about the Celtic gods in general, I could refer to them as the Tua de Danann. Or, for short, I could simply say the Tua. However, for no other reason than to farm angry comments because I think it's funny, I have decided to purposely refer to this pantheon as the Tuatha. Anyway, back to the story. So, the Tuatha leave the fairy mound, Celtic heaven, and descend to Earth. Once there, the Tuatha make Nuadu their new king. Then, the Tuatha discovers that the Earth is ruled by a race of giants known as the Firbolg. As an interesting factoid, the Firbolg call their leaders Ardri. This means High King. According to legend, the Firbolg were the first to ever use this title. Now, the Firbolg and the Tuatha go to war with each other. They fight twice, actually. During their first fight, 100,000 Firbolg die, and Nuadu loses his right arm. And since Nuadu now does not have his arm, the Tuatha decide that he is no longer fit to be king. Why? Because the Tuatha are extremely superficial. For these beings, appearance is everything. In their minds, Nuadu is now imperfect, and therefore he cannot be king. And so, the Tuatha choose a being called Bres as their new king. Now, Bres is half Firbolg, half Tuatha, and once he is king, Bres sides with the Firbolg, and he helps them subjugate the Tuatha. Bres then remains in power for the next 7 years, and during that time, Nuadu recovers his lost arm. With the help of the god Dian Sech, Nuadu is given a new arm, and from that day onwards, Nuadu is known as Nuadu of the Silver Arm. Nuadu then returns to the Tuatha, and the Tuatha fight the Firbolg a second time. The Tuatha win this second fight, and the Firbolg are vanquished. Mostly. A few Firbolg manage to escape and they reproduce. Some of these descendants, by the way, will later be killed by the Irish demigod hero, Cú Chulainn. Hang on, I should probably butcher that one too. Cú Chulainn. Get mad, nerds! After the Firbolg are dealt with, humanity inherits the Earth. You'll notice that at no point I mentioned the creation of mankind. That's not because I forgot. If there was ever a story in Celtic mythology exploring the creation of mankind, that story did not survive until this day. All we know is that after the Firbolg are defeated, humanity is there. You are free to fill in the gap with any headcanon you want. And speaking of headcanon, during the conflict between the Tuatha and the Firbolg, around that time, Angus probably descended to Earth as well. I say this because in some of the sources describing the events between the Tuatha and the Firbolg, in some of those texts, Angus is present during that conflict. So let's headcanon that Angus eventually realized that being the king of an empty kingdom is not that fun. Anyway, once humanity is in control of the world, the Tuatha return to the Fairy Mound, and every now and then, some of the Tuatha would return to the Earth once more, and meddle with the affairs of man. The end. And that, kids, is Celtic mythology. Not all of it, of course, that was just enough Celtic mythology for you to be ready for my next video. So, join me next time, and we will finally talk about how powerful the Celtic gods actually are. Unless you're watching this video in the future, because if you are, good news! I already uploaded that video, and you can find a link to that video in the description of this video. But if you're not interested in power levels, that's fine. I still thank you for watching this, I hope you got something out of this video, and I wish you the best. The rest of you, however, you and I have an appointment. Next time, we will find out how many Celtic gods it takes to punch a carrot. See you there!